This is Jeff Michelle. Thanks for joining me today. I'm pleased to be able to share with you the highlights of my diving experiences. Enjoy the trip. In December of 1999, we toured the British Virgin Islands on a liveaboard yacht, the Cuenlaw, which sails from the BVI capital of Tortola. The Cuenlaw is a beautiful 105-foot trimaran sailing vessel. Diving is generally done from a Zodiac, which can place divers over the choice sites. On several occasions, we saw schools of large tarpon gliding majestically through the water. Most dives were at depths of between 30 and 70 feet in typical Caribbean conditions, excellent visibility and little current. The variety of colorful fish, coral, and sponges is evident. During a night dive, we see orange cup coral feeding with its polyps exposed. Here is a camouflaged Caribbean reef octopus. These shy creatures are usually seen exclusively at night. Can readily see its ability to change shape and color, attempting to meld into its surroundings for protection. Here we see it spread its body in a distinctive parachute pattern to attack and engulf its prey. This scrawled filefish, normally wary of divers, seems intrigued by the camera's lens. The spiny Caribbean lobster hides in protective recesses during the day, but is commonly seen on night dives. A small spiny puffer glides smoothly near the bottom. Here we see an unusual crustacean known as a slipper or Spanish lobster. Now back diving during the day, we observe the colorful queen angelfish. From below, we note the distinctive snout of a large spotted eagle ray accompanied by several remoras. Its missing tail is most likely the result of a shark encounter. As it swims away, one can see its characteristic spotted dorsum. This solitary barracuda seems inquisitive about the approaching divers. blue trumpet fish glides gracefully between the corals. If you look closely, you can see not one but two snails called flamingo tongues with their distinctive mantles. Here, a pair of white-spotted filefish exhibit the rhythmic movements of their ventral and dorsal fins. A tiny Pedersen shrimp dances on a sea anemone. The alluring feathers of a tube worm wave in the current. Several small butterfly fish flit around the coral. This is a trunk fish rooting around for food. Here we see the crow's nest and foremast of the wreck of the Rhone. Probably the most renowned dive site in the Virgin Islands, the Rhone is home to this large dogfish snapper, which seems unconcerned with the many divers. The Rhone, a 310-foot sailing steamer, sank during a hurricane on October 29, 1867. Lying on its side on a sandy bottom, one can see schools of jacks through these arches made up of supporting beams of the ship's now rotted deck. The wreck, famous as the location of filming of the movie The Deep, is home to a very large green moray eel, which guards one of the many openings in the hull. One can peer through ancient portholes. Some even have the glass intact after all these years. The wreck is home to many species of sea life, like this magnificent adult spotted drum, and the spiny lobster. A night dive of the wreck reveals other creatures. Here, a beautifully colored parrotfish nestles down for the night. A spotted moray eel wriggles backward to avoid the glare of our lights, and a spindly-legged arrow crab tries to escape. A huge porcupine fish swims inside the coral-encrusted skeleton of the Rhone. A basket star is out for an evening stroll. And finally, we come upon an enormous sea turtle, which must weigh upwards of 300 pounds. The barnacles on its shell attest to its advanced age. We hope you've enjoyed the highlights of diving in the British Virgin Islands. Join us again soon, when we'll be in the Western Pacific, diving in the Republic of Palau. Here we are in Palau. Palau is part of Micronesia in the Western Pacific, about 500 miles east of the Philippines. The variety of sea life was remarkable. Some examples are the striking clown triggerfish, these rare batfish, and a school of copper glass sides. Puffer fish in the Pacific are quite large in general. At night, this puffer shows off its intricate design pattern. This school of fish we call yellow lights for obvious reasons. This magnificent emperor angelfish annoys a large crinoid or feather star. Watch the star's reaction. You can well imagine why this fellow is called the unicorn fish. Here's a poisonous feathery lionfish striking its prey. The tips of the spines are toxic and a sting can seriously injure a diver. These equally dangerous spiny lionfish pose for our camera. This moray eel seems very docile, but they can be nasty. The South Pacific is noted for the many different shaped and colored soft corals. Numerous crustaceans abound. This tiny porcelain crab in a carpet anemone is less than 1 inch long. A hairy slipper lobster makes its way over the colorful coral. And a hermit crab scurries to escape the intensity of our lights. This large and friendly fish is called a Napoleon wrasse. Funny shaped, isn't it? Schools of Moorish idols and pyramidal butterfly fish are favorite morsels of the sharks in these waters. Here's the most famous and popular dive site in Palau, Blue Corner. The top of the submerged wall is at a depth of about 100 feet and is at the confluence of several distinct currents. The nutrient-rich currents attract many fish to the area, which in turn bring the many sharks for which this site is renowned. Notice that the sharks are surfing the current, hardly swimming at all. They seem to appear out of nowhere, ascending from thousands of feet below. Because of the strong currents found at this site, divers use devices called reef hooks to attach themselves to the reef and remain stationary, letting the action float by them. A reverse drift dive, if you will. Sea anemones, with their ever-present anemone fish, are fascinating. These fish are quite small, from 1 to 3 inches long, and are almost always found in pairs. The anemone's brightly colored tentacles are poisonous to most fish, but not to these little guys, who use the anemone for protection. Here's an extremely rare finding, a red anemone. Giant clams are abundant in the waters of Palau. While drifting the Oolong Channel, we came upon these huge giant clams. Each was about 6 to 7 feet long. Do you see the two openings in each clam? That's why they're called bivalves. Further up along the Oolong Channel, we encountered a 200-foot patch of distinctive lettuce coral. Of course, we saw many turtles, such as this loggerhead turtle. And on one of our night dives, we were fortunate to have this chap show off his intricately patterned shell. Palau is home to the largest of the triggerfish, the Titan triggerfish. Don't let the apparent smile fool you. They are very aggressive and are known to nip off the ends of divers' flippers. We were very excited to encounter several large reef cuttlefish. Related to the octopus and the squid, they are in the class of cephalopods. Boy, are they graceful. Like the octopus, cuttlefish can change color instantaneously to camouflage themselves. For added protection, they can even change the texture of their skin. Thanks for joining us in Palau. We'll see you in Yap. Well, we're in Yap for a few days to dive with giant manta rays. But first, let's take a look at some tiny creatures which we came across. Nudibranchs are shellless snails, characterized by a pair of tentacles on top of the head and a tuft of feathery gills on the rear part of the back. This nudibranch has its egg sacs attached. Though most nudibranchs are 2 to 3 inches long, these individuals are less than an inch. Here a flatworm laboriously works its way on the sand. Suddenly it takes flight. Look at it dance. This relative of the seahorse is called a pipefish. On our way to see the mantis, we bumped into the bizarre alligator fish. It measures about 3 feet. Look at its eyes and snout. It looks menacing, but it's harmless. Though one may encounter mantas at any depth, on this dive we settled on the sandy bottom at around 70 feet near a cleaning station and waited for the mantas to come in. We weren't disappointed. Mantas feed on tiny organisms known as plankton, and the presence of plankton in the water usually decreases the visibility. When the mantas feed, they roll out their horned appendages, which act as giant scoops. These mantas have wingspans of 9 to 12 feet. The underbelly is generally white with characteristic markings which allow them to be individually identified. Our time with the mantas of Yap has only heightened the anticipation of our visit to the island of San Benedicto off the Pacific coast of Mexico, where we hope to interact with the largest mantas in the world. See you there! In May 2000, we set out from Cabo San Lucas at the tip of the Baja Peninsula on the west coast of Mexico. Our destination? The Revilla Hijitos, a group of desolate volcanic islands about 250 miles south-southwest of Cabo. Our first landfall was the island of San Benedicto, home to the largest mantas on the planet. At a dive site known as the Boiler, one encounters mantas anywhere from the surface to 100 feet down. These mantas have wingspreads of 15 to 20 feet. They can literally blot out the sun. The mantas here are almost all accompanied by large remoras, usually a pair. Though the mantas are plankton eaters and pose no threat to divers, the remoras can bite. Like mantas all over the world, Each has unique markings from which divers can identify them. The mantas of San Benedicto love to interact with divers. We often swam with three or four mantas at a time. Though the opportunity to be with the mantas is what drew us here, other sea life was abundant. This is a clarion angelfish, unique to this region. Note that the dive sites are predominantly volcanic with sparse coral formations. This is a triggerfish commonly found here. These are blue-spotted trevallies. This is a Mexican hogfish and a pair of Moorish idols. A peacock flounder glides near the rocky bottom. And a dangerous scorpionfish darts from spot to spot. An overnight boat ride brings us to the isolated Roca Partita, a barren rock virtually in the middle of nowhere. When we entered the water on our first dive at Roca Partita, we came upon a huge mass of fish composed of thousands of large jacks. This so-called bait ball measured several hundred feet across. The fish apparently gathered this way as protection from their major predators, sharks, which circle the bait ball in search of strays. Four dolphins swim by us, but we were not able to get close to them. At a depth of 90 to 100 feet, Roca Partita was strewn with many large and aggressive green moray eels. The third island we visited is Socorro Island. Once in the water, I followed this white-tipped reef shark to its den. Thank you. San Benedicto for our last dives with the mantis. The Somar 5, the only vessel bringing divers here, keeps a log of all the mantis seen at the site. Over the years, more than 100 have been identified, and many seem to return here annually. Here's one we swam with, which had not been seen before. Note the very striking semilunar marks on its belly. Because this one was previously not identified, we were fortunate to be able to log it and name it. We named it Michelle. They are so large, yet so graceful. We feel extremely privileged to have been able to interact with these magnificent giants of the sea. July 2000 finds us in the Caribbean at the Little Cayman Beach Resort in the Cayman Islands. Wall diving. The north side of the island is home to a magnificent coral-studded edifice called the Bloody Bay Wall. Jacques Cousteau considered this the most beautiful wall in the world. There are many swim-throughs from the top of the wall, from which divers emerge on the sheer side with drop-offs of thousands of feet. Sea creatures inhabit the area, such as this very large French angelfish. A gray angelfish. And the very colorful queen angelfish. Many large lobsters can be observed even during the day. A school of small Caribbean reef squid line up for my camera. Southern stingray glides along the sand. A small jack is in tow, looking for scraps. here's an eagle ray with a very long, slender tail. Nurse sharks of varying sizes are not uncommon. And we saw small hawksbill turtles on almost every dive. Varieties of parrotfish were abundant, including these very large rainbow parrotfish. You can see why this is called a white-spotted filefish. It even deploys its horn for us. Though well camouflaged, if you look closely, you can find scorpionfish hidden in the coral. Colorful coral and sponges are everywhere. This strawberry basket sponge only shows its true colors when I shine my light on it. The colorful sponges are home to a variety of creatures, such as lobster, brittle stars, and small shrimp. Sea life ranges from huge barrel sponges to tiny Christmas tree worms and the delicate tentacles of a sea anemone. An adult blue-scrawled filefish glides through the beautiful soft coral and sea fans. Here, friendly groupers like to be petted. At the time we were at Little Cayman, a bottlenose dolphin enjoyed interacting with divers. We were lucky enough to be with this tame fellow on several dives. Here I am scratching his belly. He seems to be having as much fun as we are. This definitely was the highlight of our trip. Late in our trip, I came across a grouper which had backed itself into an opening in the coral. To my surprise, this was a cleaning station. Just look at all the cleaner shrimp and the tiny fish picking off the microscopic parasites. Best example of a cleaning station I have ever encountered. I'm pleased I could capture it on video. And so our wonderful trip to Little Cayman ends. I'll see you soon when we visit the world-famous Galapagos Islands. In November 2000, we visited the Galapagos Islands. The Galapagos are on the equator in the Pacific Ocean, about 500 miles off the coast of Ecuador. Our first dive site was along North Seymour Island. As soon as we descended on our first dive, we saw this school of golden cowrays. A playful sea lion stirs up the sand. There were many reef sharks at Seymour. Like the Revilla Hejados, the Galapagos are volcanic in origin, and there is little coral formation because the water temperatures are too cool for coral growth. The confluence of several currents at the Galapagos brings an abundance of nutrients to the area, hence the massive number of fish, especially the large fish or pelagics. An eagle ray and a cow ray can barely make their way into the strong current. You can imagine how hard I was kicking just to stay up with them. These are the characteristic angelfish in these waters, the king angelfish. Here's a giant manta with remoras. Topside, we toured the island to see many interesting land species. The many sea lions were quite approachable. Here's a nice example of a blue-footed booby. There were hundreds of frigate birds. It's mating season. Look at the puffed-out red throat of the males. This occurs only when they're mating. And this prehistoric-looking creature is a marine iguana. Our next stop was Darwin Island, the northernmost of the Galapagos archipelago. We dove predominantly at Darwin's Arch. The waters were teeming with schools of dolphin. It was hard to get close to these wild ones, but occasionally we could. On every dive, we saw hundreds of huge hammerhead sharks in the 10 to 14 foot range. Whoa, that was close. Here's an octopus out in broad daylight. It jets away when a moray eel approaches. And here is Mr. Big, Señor Grande, a whale shark, the largest fish in the sea. This one was particularly big, close to 50 feet. Plankton eaters, they are no threat to divers. This is what we came here to see, and we weren't disappointed. An unbelievable experience. The sheer numbers of fish in these waters is incredible. At Wolf Island, we met up with the nasty sharks, the Galapagos sharks. But first, a large marble ray. And a large bright yellow trumpet fish. Peacock flounders. Come to think of it, everything was large in the Galapagos. We often dove in swift currents with lots of surge. I think you can see what I mean. Okay, here come the Galapagos sharks. One gets near one of our group. Look at the diver holding on in the fierce current. There were schools of sharks just everywhere. Our last dive site was Cousins Island. Here is a beautiful spotted eagle ray using its snout to feed in the sand. This large green sea turtle let us get real close. This is an ugly 3-foot-long scorpion fish. Look at its lips and eyes. And And we did see some little stuff, like nudibranchs and this magnificent seahorse. This was truly a week of remarkable diving. February 2001 finds us in the Central American country of Belize. Belize, a land of Mayan ruins and wonderful Caribbean diving, was formerly known as British Honduras. We encountered many unusual examples of sea life while diving here. Here, a lobster and a gray angelfish seem to coexist well. As does this large green moray eel with several banded coral shrimp. Some tube worms retract their plumes when we approach. But soon deploy them again. Here's a tiny juvenile drum. They always seem so nervous. And a gathering of garden eels. A southern stingray dusts off the sand. And there's a beautiful specimen of a white-spotted filefish. See the snout on that fish? It's a hogfish. This large black grouper has something in its mouth. If you look closely, you can see that it has swallowed a whole parrotfish. You can see the head and beak of the parrotfish protruding from the grouper's mouth. At night, we saw many large crabs. And both Caribbean spiny lobsters. As well as spotted spiny lobsters. Talk about dignity. Here's a sponge brittle star wrapped around some coral and a rare decorator crab. The strobes under our boat attracted large tarpon on every night dive. An interesting grouping of colorful sponges and coral.
The
saw many barracuda and several eagle rays. A yellow three-spot juvenile damselfish defends its territory. Look how the eyes move on this rock hind. Here's a large school of doctor fish intent on feeding. Two flamingo tongues cling to a sea fan. A large trunkfish swims among the coral. Note the spots on this yellow-tailed damselfish. These chubs have unusual white blotches. This is a very rare finding. This is a good example of working together. On our final night dive, I found a worm dancing rhythmically and three small but beautiful Caribbean reef squid. Look at how their eyes shine in our lights. This type of posturing is usually indicative of apprehension. Yep, they inked me. There were lovely trumpet fish and many spotted moray eels. A cowfish inspects a barrel sponge, then retreats. On the final dive of this trip, we came across a gigantic sea turtle. It measured about 5 or 6 feet long. A really huge specimen, very special. And so ends our trip to Belize and this video. I hope to see you soon for some more underwater adventures. Bye for now.